2, 1, 2. Shut down the music. Selector. Wait, hold it, selector. It's time we do something different. First, give it up for your dancers. Clap, clap, now come. Make noise. Bring it down in for your dancers. Now wait, hold it, selector. Selector.
Yeah.
Get a good song then. One wants to be funky.
Yeah, Ranger.
Want to make the people then want to dance.
Okay.
Yeah.
Come down, my selector. Come on.
Shut your mouth now. Shut up. Attack it for the mic. You can't talk when I talk. In fact, turn off your mic. We don't even talk. We need to play the music. Shut up.
We gonna have a ball in there, Jill.
Middletown, USA, New York City, wherever you're from, Grand, wherever the hell we are, let me hear your mission now! Are you ready for some comedy? You sound like a bunch of chumps. What's up? It ain't but 6 of y'all in that motherfucker. Y'all gonna make more noise than that. Now, we gonna try it one more time. New York City, are you ready for some comedy? This thing started right proper, like coming to the stage, your host for the city. You see them on Showtime at the Apollo Comedy Hour. You see them on Death Comedy Jam. You see them on Route 17 coming up. This motherfucker driving mad slow. That's why he's late. Put your hands together for your host tonight. Give it up for Mr. Freddie Rice.
Selector,
come
on,
come DJ, where the DJ at? Oh, he back there. Nigga, you late, man. What happened, dog? You couldn't find a crate man tonight? You find somebody to lick your shit? Okay, first of all, I want to thank each and every one of you on behalf of the NAACP and Ms. Paul Medina of Black Paris Productions for coming out. Put your hands together for yourselves tonight. Man. Two things we got straight now. We got some news, information, stuff like that, and then we're gonna get started. Okay, number one, all you people up top, I don't know why the fuck you went up there. You got all these seats down here. What y'all got to do? Your test results came back? What the fuck? You can't sit with the population? What's wrong with you motherfuckers up there? All these seats. What happened? Shit the fuck up. Just hollering out shit now. A little hostile section up there. That must be section 8. Yo, hostile like a motherfucker. Wait, we have to make way for the shiny lady. Come on, have a seat, sweetie. Come on in, have a seat. Don't walk next to no microwave. Your ass will blow the fuck up. Thanks for coming. Sorry you came late. Hey, why don't you come on down? Move down here, man. Fuck all that. That's too, you know? What? Wait a minute. It's one ignorant person at a time. Huh? A little white girl up there is jumping in the house.
They don't want to come down there. That's why. We don't want to be around.
All right, look, got some good news and some bad news for you tonight. Shit happens. Besides the fact that we black. Okay, so you want the good news or the bad news first? Bad news. Bad news is one of the artists who were on the bill cannot be here tonight, Mr. Tracy Morgan. But it's all right, calm down. He asked me to let you all know, I'm gonna tell you, and he apologized for not being here, but the man, well, get the fuck out. The man has a career, unlike some people in this motherfucking room. And he got sent down to LA to do some work. Is that all right with y'all? So give it up for Mr. Tracy Morgan in his absence. When was the last time you got sent somewhere other than your P.O.? You dumb son of a bitch. Okay, now here's the good news. And although Tracy won't be here, I have personally selected some of the hottest comedians to come out and show their love in his place. Now, is that good news? All right, now you're okay. I'm probably saying like, ooh, ooh. Now, you don't know as the night goes on, because they ain't in here yet. No, I'm only fucking I'm just fucking man. We got tonight's show is going to consist of a whole bunch of comedians as soon as they pace. It's going to be, we got same people that are on it. The rest of the crew is here. And in addition to that, we have a hot young man named Will, you just seen on Def Jam a couple of weeks ago. Also on Jimmy Matt, that you've seen on HBO Snaps. Also, who else we got? My man Sleepy Floyd is here tonight. So, what the fuck y'all want? Huh? Did I do my thing or what? Alright, Tracy couldn't be here, so you know what? We need to just, you wanna come downstairs, bro? I know what the problem is, you're too tight. Look at you, look. That tight ass jacket. What's wrong with you? If you gonna faint and come over the banister, how dare you come in here wearing a damn tutu? That jacket is too tight, nigga. What's wrong with you? I can see him now. He gonna be like, chill. We gonna have a ball tonight. All right, now let me know where. I know I'm in Middletown, right? We in Middletown. So who else? Is anybody from out of town here? Or? Everybody's from fucking Middletown. I just gotta explain why the crowd is so small. Okay, cool. This is a nice place to come. I'm glad you came, man. You cool, man? Where the Puerto Ricans at? Puerto Rico! Whoa! Oh, so we got a Puerto Rican DJ. What happened? That stolen car broke down on your brother?
I don't know what happened. It was working when I stole it. Mare con puñeta, bro. Cabrón. Now I gotta go carry the buses myself. This is a Bucci.
This is Boricua right there.
Look at this thing here, all the white on it. Bus, he playing. Bus.
Boy, what's up with that hat, yo? Look at that hat, is tight as shit. Hat just sitting up here, ugly. You just gotta hold your nose, cause that part of my hat. This shit is little tiny hat. Oh, look at these lovely ladies here. Glad y'all came out. Now, wait, you got a little couple here. You a couple? No? Yeah.
Little baby, you know.
Is you know, hey, you Italian? Oh, so what are you, Irish?
No shit. Top of the day to you, fella. I'm so glad you can fucking bring your body up here. Just to be a part of the show. Glad you can make it. Maybe you can take this fella here with you. Hmm? Give him a nice.
Oh, I know he got no bowling shoes. Hey, bro. You know I got love for you, right? But don't go trying to walk around this motherfucker. You'll be slipping everywhere. Those are real bowling shoes. What, you got a little tournament after the show? I like you, man. I like you. We gotta give you a name. And a theme song. Give the theme song first. That's your theme song, and your name is gonna be White Breeze. It's suitable. You got on all white. Oh, you know, I think, what, you Santeria? Is that what that is? Puerto Ricans know what I'm talking about. You know, you gotta wear the white, you know, it's a religious thing. If it's that, I'll leave you alone. If not, I'm gonna jump in your ass for the rest of the night. You better be Santeria. You better say, Ole, that's it, puppy. That's it, I gotta put it some gato. Yeah, make sure that you know, hey, you all cool. That's just, your wife, sir? Married? I'm just picking on y'all because I can see you. You're supposed to have a spotlight. I'm not supposed to be able to see you. So, take off that coat. What's wrong with you? You got low blood, girl? Take off that coat. The black woman's supposed to be cold. What the fuck wrong with you? Nice little older couple over there. How you doing, sir? Is that your wife? Oh, shit. How long you been married? You don't know.
Oh, shit, hon. How long has it been? Seems like a lifetime.
It's terrible.
I bet you she knows. How long you been married, man?
You not married? Or how long you been fucking? Hey, it's gonna be an adult show tonight. I hope y'all can handle it. Y'all like, whoa, but he almost had a heart attack. Oh, Lord. That young boy said, fuck it. It's the end booming up with this VP around here. Can't be cussing like that around here. We're gonna lose our life. Hey, you know, they try to be, and then when they see me, they're gonna try to hold that shit together. You know, that's a big man. You know, for the black people, they gotta keep a low blow. Let somebody get out of hand, this motherfucker. You ain't see the riot yet. These people, that old nigga right there had them people by the back of the neck and kill them.
Breathe, nigga, breathe. I got your ass now.
Oh, we ain't here for that anyway. We come in peace, we gonna have a good time. You all right over there, man? Cool the game? All right, can you see everything? Cool the game. Now, you're not exempt. I want you to know that. Just because you're in a wheelchair, I'll get you too. And you ain't gonna do what you wanna do, roll up on me? Go ahead. Thanks for coming out. Give a round of applause, y'all. Thanks for being here. Look at Poppy over there. Goddamn, boy. One birth, the whole section gonna clear out. You just big. You can't help yourself, huh? What, one burrito, two fucking minutes? Mm.
I live to be in America.
You all right, man? You look kind of tight over there. Cool. Don't look at me like you're hard. What the fuck you gonna do? You start chasing me, I drop a point, you have to make a decision. What? I'm gonna give you the next time, man. You gotta cheat again. Oh my God. I'm having fun. We're gonna have a ball tonight. Don't you look so damn serious either. You, man. You, yes, you. Sitting there looking like that. That's your daughter? No? Your family member? That's your daughter right there? Oh, that's why you're looking serious. You don't want to be here. You just protecting her from Raheem. He look like a little sleazy nigga, too. He probably whispering shit in her head.
Look out to the show. I want to eat your pussy, all right? Let me suck on one of your titties, kid. Oh, just leave me in the house like you did last week.
Your mother ain't gonna... I'm sorry. I'm just... But she got upset. Well, you know she's fucking, though, you know? How old are you, young lady? How old are you? 15? 17?
Oh, she's bugging.
But he ain't getting no pussy. He ain't the problem. It's that old nigga right there. He gonna start up on that after the show.
And you get rid of that nigga right there. Send him to the dome and put him in there. He'll go, throw some popcorn, nigga.
This is nice, man. This motherfucker's kind of empty, but we gonna have a ball. Look like we ain't supposed to be in this motherfucker, don't we? Look like we snuck in this bitch, man. But this shit is. This look like it could have been the first slave comedy show. That's right. Don't get it twisted now. We comedians have been around for black comedy. It's been around forever. Always been a funny black man. Don't get it twisted. That's right. We was on the plantations. The only thing we could do at times to make it through the day was do just what we doing tonight. Have a comedy show. Slave comedy jam. We gather up, we wouldn't be supposed to be in the same place at the same time. They know, they these are the researchers for real, NAACP. They'd sneak in a barn, a shed, and have a funny-ass comedy show, just like this. Be a slave host. I'll be the slave host. Look at him. Supposed to be thanking all y'all for coming on out here tonight. Now we've got a good comedy show. What's gonna be happening, y'all? Some of the funniest comedians what y'all just ever gonna see. Before we get this thing here started, I'll be your host, Rufus. I got me a couple of announcements I need to be making. First off, if y'all hear something was funny, and y'all want to laugh and jump for joy,
down some hills and come down here and kill us all, yeah. Now I want to be giving a big old shout, nigga, out to Miss Hattie Tubman and the Underground Railroad Production for making this here happen for us. Don't you all make no noise around him? Now look at him. I was fit to bring on the first comedian, and Lord, it be he funny as hell. Lord, he been blowing up plantations all in the South. Some of y'all's gonna know who he is when I calls his name. Some of y'all say, preacher got to know who you is to find out who this is. Now he a little bit angry, so if you come out here and y'all don't go to laugh right away, don't y'all get mad around him. Cause Mass will come down here and kill your dad. Y'all know who he is. Seen him tied to a tree last week. He was picking cotton the week before that. Coming to the stage, the angriest slave on the plantation, Mr. Nat Turner. Good evening, all my brothers and my sisters. And some white folk too. First of all, I want to be thanking all y'all for coming out here tonight. Y'all liable to not see me no more after this here show. Cause I done killed 52 crackers, I'm looking to kill another. I just got me a couple of jokes that I want to be telling around here. My first jokes for the night is, I bet y'all didn't know that the master wife pussy stank ahead.
I love this shit. I love comedy. I get to travel all over the world, meet people. Some places I go to I don't really like being. Last year I ended up in Atlanta during the Olympics. That was some experience. I tell you something. Too many people from other countries, people from all over the world were in Atlanta, bro. I come out my hotel, the first dude I seen, he was from London, England. But here's the kicker. He was a pimp. He in front of the hotel mad because he can't find his hoes.
Where's me, bitches? Anyone see the bloody whores around here? Every tells me 40 quid. If I catch you, I'm gonna stop a bloody mud hole in my ass. Stupid bitch.
I go upstairs to my hotel room, I'm trying to get some sleep. I'm being kept awake all night by two gay Mexicans. I know they was gay. All night I'm hearing shit like this. Issy, where you going, eh? You're no Phoenix.
What about my balls, Issy, huh? No, they say your balls are way too bumpy, man. Ouch, take that out, you're hurting me. That's not your finger, ow. You're gonna make me bleed, ow, Issy. You're killing me.
Then I went to one of those convenience stores in Atlanta. It was cool, you know, but there was one of them Indian dudes there, the Punjab guys. He didn't really want me in the store. So he started saying shit, put that back, no. You don't buy, leave my store. So I got a little upset being a young black man, you know, I felt treated unjustly. So I started cussing at him. I figured, well, I'm cussing him, he cussing me, I'm going about my business. We both have a good day, but it went a little different. I cussed at him, he put curses on me. I said, fuck you, no. You will never be fucking me. May your children grow up very slowly, suffering bad in the public school systems of America. Get out! Kiss my ass. No, I will never kiss the buttocks. But may small projectiles be piercing from your backside, causing much pain and discomfort every time you go to remove your bowel system. Get out! Suck my dick. No, I will never lick the penis. But may a very bad burning sensation be piercing from your penis every time you go to urinate. Get out of my stomach. This was chasing me out of Atlanta. I had to leave after this last experience. I go on a Chinese restaurant. I figure I'd get something to eat. The dude behind the counter was like one of them old Kung Fu movies. He talking, but the words coming out later. I go on there, I'm like, look here, man, give me all the shrimp fried rice.
Shrimp fried rice. Good then, brother. Coming right up, right? 5 minutes then, right now.
I'm like, oh, shit. It's a big dude walking in the restaurant, he hungry too.
Look here, man, give me number two, just like the picture. Number two right there. Right away, number two. Right away, brother. Number two. Good then. Coming right up.
Wait, hold it. My pussy's out.
Why you don't let mouth them move over the world, they're gonna come out there, huh? You thinking I'm gonna mash up your world this time? Pussy clap.
Listen, yeah, what was crying?
That was funny.
She didn't think so. She's still mad at me. I said, that daughter was fucking. She ain't laughing at nothing all night.
I'm sorry, man. You didn't realize this was adult comedy?
You ain't heard nothing yet.
I'm clean compared to some of the shit you might hear tonight.
Believe me, you ain't lost.
You go, hey, bro, your girl kind of small. No, she not. Ooh. Boy, she got headlights. And they on. Brother, the high beams are in my eyes. Ooh, she sitting there like this. Mmm. I can't do nothing with these damn things. They're big and big and big. How you doing, Jesus?
Yeah, you know who he is looking at.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, I'm Jesus. I got a camp, dude. People follow me wherever I go. Fucking A, dude. This is my girl. She thinks I'm God, man. She does everything I tell her to do. Watch this. Lick my balls.
This is what you're doing. She's like...
Let me give a shout out to my Puerto Rican people before I leave. Where my Puerto Rican was at? Puerto Rico! Black people! All right, Puerto Rico, I think you better keep it down. I love you all. I love my Puerto Rican brothers and sisters. I love you all to death. See, I live in the South Bronx. I ain't got no choice. Where I go, I'm waiting for the first Puerto Rican home improvement show to come on TV. It's gonna be the bomb. They show me shows. We show some people, you know, how to fix up shit. Of course, your programming will have nothing to do with fixing nobody's shit. It'll be something designed just for Puerto Ricans, like tools. Welcome to Julio Sanchez Rodriguez, tools for fun. And today, my friend, we're going to talk about a very important tool, the screwdriver. And most people see the screwdriver and say, that's easy, you take out the screw, that's it. But today, my friend, we got a many more function for the screwdriver. For example, let's say when you're coming home, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock in the morning, eh? You see the car, beautiful car, 1979, you go to the ground, eh? Beautiful car. There's nobody around but you and the car. You don't have the keys for the car, but you got your screwdriver. That's the same thing, the car belongs to you. Mighty, go for your car. All right, let's get this thing going, y'all. This is a Paramount Theater production brought to you by the NAACP in association with Black Paris Productions. Come on, let's let them have it. DJ, you in the house?
Yeah.
Oh, we got a dope-fiend DJ.
Hey, nigga, what you want to hear next? I got the Lost Boys in my pocket. Give me $5, I'll give you the biggie double, kid.
You ready, though?
Yeah, dog.
Okay, we gonna pump this up, right? Proper, like, coming to the stage, give it up to your first comedian. You've seen him on Showtime like Apollo. You're sure to see him on Def Jam next season. Put your hands together out the Boogie Down Bronx. Come on, clap your hands, stop your feet. Give it up for Mr. Snoopy. Hello.
You know, all the seats wasn't tilted up tonight. So we gonna have to cut your funds. My son don't wanna hear that shit. My son be like, Daddy, where Pampers at, Daddy? Daddy, where Pampers? But it's real nice and it's real positive, man. I can have, I'm gonna tell you something. Lately, where my age has been put me at, it's been some real bullshit places. He been sending me to some real crazy places. I'm a little pissed off about it. He sent me to one place deep in the Bronx. I seen the craziest shit in the world. I seen the undercover crackhead in a nightclub on the dance floor looking for crack, acting like nobody knew what the hell he was doing.
Everything was cool, you know what I mean? We wasn't beefing, I guess it was the popcorn, you know what I'm saying?
She was quiet, I was quiet. We get outside to the car. Mind you now, we on 23rd Street. 8th Avenue, downtown. We get in the car. So I figured the popcorn was real good. Cause just before I was ready to pull off, she grabbed my leg. I said, oh shit, it's on. Now I'm not trying to talk about, you know, no one, but Spanish sisters are some of the most passionate women that you can get involved with. They don't mind expressing their emotions. They really don't. They don't give a fuck where. Man, honey, hit me off a little something. She went down, yeah? What? I was like this to God.
Thank you.
She hit me off just when I was getting ready to reach that orgasm. She started that bullshit again. She told me, Ben Aki. I said, what the hell you want me to bring the keys to you for, girl? Just confusing me, man. So I kind of figured out what she was talking about. So we got, you know, I got in the backseat of the car. I'm doing my thing. You know me. I'm a true brother. The police started coming down the block, checking people's registration on their windshield wipers. I said, yo, chill, 5-0, 5-0. She gonna start that shit again. She told me, uno momento. I said, I'm trying to keep the momento, and you just shit the fuck up. Crazy as hell. And I almost got in a fight with a Spanish brother one time. She knocked on me, knocked on my door, man, right? Rattle. I said, don't know Rattle live here. 5 minutes later, a brother knocked on my door. Don't sleep, there's a fire in the building. So why nobody tell me that shit? He said, Julio told me that shit in Spanish, boom. Just confused me sometimes. Fellas, give it up for the ladies over here. Give it up for the ladies, fellas. I'm thinking that soft shit. Ladies, clap for your damn self. Make some noise, ladies. When you gave a person all of your emotions, you gave them every damn thing. And in the bottom of the night, they tell you something stupid like they need some space. What the hell is space? This girl called me beaten one day. You took my stuff, let me see me. You took my stuff. I said, wait a minute. I didn't take your shit. You said you needed some space. Well, there's the space where that sofa used to be at. There's the space where that TV used to be at. Once you go look in the closet, honey, ain't not much space up in that mother. And y'all ladies need to stop. I'm gonna tell y'all something. Y'all getting a little bit carried away with y'all little sexual fantasies. Y'all getting a little carried away. Skill can't even tell me she wanna try something different. She gonna ask me to hit her off. We in the mall. She asked me to hit her off. In the mall. In the mall. Now I'm like, I'm a thoroughbred. But in the mall, I ain't trying to go to game, no jail or no coochie. But the thought alone made me think about it. That, hey, she said, Sleepy, they got mirrors. You know, a brother loves the mirrors. You know, we love looking at ourselves in the motherfucking mirror. So I thought about it. I'm a little brother. I creeped in that motherfucker. You know me. I started tagging it. Looking at myself. You a fine motherfucker, boy. You all right, kid. Much love, kid. Y'all need to stop that. I almost got busted. Now, let me ask y'all something. Let me chase this down. Ladies, I know y'all been having some problems with the men, and I'm here to address that situation. Some of y'all brothers are not expressing yourself in the bedroom. Ladies, clap if you can agree with that. Clap, clap, ladies, if you can agree with that. Some of y'all brothers are a little bit too cool in the bedroom. Y'all are so cool when y'all make love. Y'all don't make no damn noise. Y'all just make faces. Y'all make the coochie quiet as hell. But y'all like this here. Oh! Oh, I'm screaming like a motherfucker over there. I'm a real man.
Show your love.
Now we gotta do the same thing back for him. Coming to the stage, I want y'all to pump it up real hard and heavy. Clap your hands and stomp your feet. Make a whole lot of noise for him. Let's get this shit started right now. Give it up for my man, man. You see him on Showtime at the Apollo. Apollo Comedy Hour. HBO Snacks. Give it up for your uncle, my uncle Jimmy Bad.
I'm smoking boom in the whole day. straight on back. Brooklyn always in the house. I love Brooklyn, man. But there's another group in Brooklyn making some noise. These for your young people. All the people, pay attention. Pay attention, or you're going to get left back. See, I don't have no problem with Biggie. I'm telling you, Drew Mafia, I had no problem. I'm going to miss Biggie, but there's one little nasty, little freaking nasty, little freaking girl in the pool. Lil' Kim. That's all I'm talking about. Just make my hips gyrate talking about Lil' Kim. Ladies, this is for y'all. Here is her lyric. I was eating sushi, playing with my coochie. Y'all, if you eat sushi, playing with your coochie, something gonna smell fishy, either sushi or the coochie. I'm gonna smell. Smell, mama, go ahead and have a good time.
She said, coochie. Coochie, coochie, coochie.
And then you got that girl from Brooklyn, that other girl, Foxy Brown. She said, but I gotta know, how many of y'all got the ill? Nah, nah. Nobody put an L in that night. Cause when you wake up, you will have an LPP. It's the lyrics. It's the lyrics. I, you know, I don't mind coming up here like Freddie said, but on the way up here, I got five speeches. Why y'all ain't warning? I come up 87, police put me up with five times, tell me I'm speaking. I said, I'm not speeding. I'm doing what the sign said. It said 84, 87 north, and that's what I'm doing. I said, you better be lucky, because I started to bring my foot up 287. That would have caught my ass. I'd have been moving. Police, any police in here? Because they asked me stupid questions. He said, you've been drinking? I said, you damn right, kid. The vodka on the floor? I said, I can lock you up for that. I said, no, you can't. This is the right place. This is the highway. And I was high and on my way before you stopped me. Ask me something dumb, bro. He said, let me see your driver's license. I said, I ain't got no driver's license. You took it from me last week. I said, I thought you was pulling my ass over to get a shit back. Stop is crazy, man. Pay attention to your kids. How many of y'all in here got kids this evening? Make some noise. Why you ain't home with them? They home alone right now. Nickelback! Pay attention to your kids. Pay attention to your kids. And stop. Our kids ain't dumb. What's this Ebonics? Ebonics. Ebonics ain't nothing. Ebonics is just another way of talking around the slave master. We had Ebonics way back. But see, young people, y'all young people learn how to take Ebonics and make it work for you. All the rappers, the most beautifulest thing in the world. Beautifulest. Yeah, 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 yeah. Ebonics. But all Ebonics did for us is give Jesse Jackson a chance to get in the forefront again. Then Jesse jumped to the issue. You know he did. He ran down south. I ran down to California and said, it's ironic. That Ebonic. Well, have our kids hooked on funny. Ain't me, money. Jesse moves his mind, don't he? The instant business father went up the wall again. Why? I don't know. Maybe the spider was white. The wall was black. Can you imagine Jesse getting some coochie? Baby. Honey. Licky, licky, sticky, sticky. Everybody get coochie, man. Coochie is good. It's good? Your coochie so good, she clapping and her coochie clapping. Pow, pow, pow. Coochie good. Ain't nothing wrong with it. Make love. You see, we got blacks, Latinos. This is a nice story. It's black, Latino. Hey, Puerto Rico. Y'all know y'all ain't nothing but black people that can speak Spanish. Y'all know that. Y'all know that, right? White folks in here. I get it down here. Because see, that's the NAACP. We all poor folks. We got something in common. We poor in the motherfucker. You don't believe it? Look around. Not too many rich people in here tonight. Not rich in money, rich in spirit. We rich in spirit, not money. I know you ain't wishing for me to get off the stage. He ain't paying me shit. By the looks of things, you ain't even getting paid. Oh, hey, cocksucker. Now that's my man Freddie Riggs. I love Freddie, man. I'd do anything for Freddie. Well, I'm not saying anything for Freddie. Some of y'all faggots say, hey. Well, if you can take a dick, you can take a joke. Mama, why you in there? Ain't that funny? Is that your wife? Well, why you holding around the leg? You just sitting there, or you want it to be your wife, or that's your friend's wife. I want you to laugh, Mama. You know, I'm serious. I don't mean to talk away from anybody, but I like to talk especially to my people, African-American people, because they catch so much hell. Latinos, y'all fall in the group, and poor white folks, pay attention. Because you're going to learn something. See, Mama, make love to women like that. See, you're about my age. See, I hit up old lady. Yo, hey. I hit it. See, I'm down with OPP. Old people's bodies. I take the old lady and crack her ass for it. I remember I hit this old lady once, she started going. I pulled out and said, hi, I'm not prepared not for this motherfucker. Love one another, man. Find some love in your heart. Listen, I gotta get out of here. I ain't getting paid too much. Look at that, a Puerto Rican Biggie Smalls. Hey, all right, Papa, que pasa? Puerto Ricans, I gotta say one thing about y'all. I love y'all. I come from the South Bronx, and I love y'all, man, but y'all piss me off. You know, you ever know something about Puerto Rican people? They always teach you the badass words first. And when you learn that shit, you go right at home and teach it to your mama. Right? We learn Spanish, they teach you. Papi, bésame el culo. Pato. We all want people, man. And I gotta say this from the bottom of my heart. I hope that ain't a motherfucker coming in here to rob our ass. That motherfucker look like another Undertaker. Hey, listen, y'all enjoy the rest of the show. That's all I got for y'all, because basically, I ain't getting picked for shit. Good night. I love y'all, man. See y'all on the side.
One more time, y'all. We'll take it back. I heard him out here talking about me, an old bastard. Got the nerve to come out here wearing a jogging suit. He ain't ran in years. That's my man. One more time, Uncle Jimmy Mack. My partner in crime. I just thought something. Come on. Where are the ladies in the house? Ladies, where you at? Make noise for me. Okay, I got something for you. Some comedy from a female's point of view. Hey. Hey. You better clap. All these men coming out here bashing you. I'm gonna bring this young lady to the stage. We're gonna have to show a lot of love, y'all. We're just gonna keep the show going. This lady hails from Georgia. I would say the name of the town, but y'all wouldn't even know it. The girl country as hell. I love her to death. You hear what I'm saying? She's on the fly and she is funny. You hear me? You hear me? I want you to make a whole lot of noise. Bring your energy and your love together. Because you've seen her on Showtime at the Apollo Comedy Hour. You've seen her on Def Jam last season. Put it up, y'all. Come on, make the noise. And give it up for Miss Barbara Carlisle.
I don't think you know Farrakhan.
trying to date all kind of men. Dated me a man with leprosy. He gave new meaning to breaking me off a little something. Why'd you have to break that part off? And I'm gonna tell you something, ladies. Anybody in here dating a Jamaican man? Oh, I'm the only one. Well, if you ain't ready for it, don't date no Jamaican man. Because Jamaican men are possessive. They like to rule you. And see, we had a handicap in our relationship because neither one of us could talk. Oh, y'all agree with that? He gonna ask me one day, could I bury a goat? I said, I ain't carrying no damn goat. Goat got four legs, let him walk his ass behind us. I ain't carrying. Find out he a pervert. Not only did he want me to jerk him, he wanted me to jerk a chicken too. Told me he wanted cocoa bread. No matter how much chocolate I put on that bread, he wouldn't eat it. Find out his favorite place is 7-Eleven. He always walking around talking about big up, big up.
Me and Clay. ain't know when a woman faking an orgasm. I know that ain't true because I don't even know no more. I had one guy ask me, why come you don't tell me when you have an orgasm? I said, hell, you ain't never around. What I'm supposed to do, get up and call your ass? And me got the smoothest ass lines in the world. He gonna look at me talking about, Barbara, you know there's an art to love making. I said, oh yeah? Well, I wish somebody had drawn you a bigger dick. Be a real artist then, wouldn't they? Michelangelo or somebody. You having a good time, sir? You having a good time? Right here. You having a good time? Tell your face. Your face don't know you having a good time. Your face thinking about paying bills. Got that Lou Rawls hairline. You'll never find a hairline like mine. You'll keep cutting and cutting your whole life through. Though I'm not trying to win no cap, baby. I used to teach school. Anybody here teach school? School teacher? Anybody got a job? I had to quit. So they don't make kids like they used to. Kids can fight now. They know their rights. Kids bringing weapons to school. But I didn't quit because of that. I quit because they started making us teach kids in school big words. Now the word for the day was fascinating. I said, whoever can make a sentence with fascinating get an A for the day. John raised his hand. I said, go ahead, John. John say, I fascinate people when I'm good. I said, ooh, you got your A. Susie raised her hand. I said, go ahead, Susie. Susie said, it's fascinating to see the rain. I said, ooh, you got your A. Mary raised her hand. I said, go ahead, Mary. Mary said, Mama, bought me a dress with 9 buttons, but I could only fascinate. Somebody got the joke late. I gotta get out of here. Mr. DJ, you got my record? Huh? You got it? All right, now, wait a minute. We're gonna do a little audience participation thing. That means y'all help out. We're gonna divide y'all up in the sections, all right? Y'all with that? All right. Over here, y'all gonna be section number 1. Right here, y'all gonna be section number 2. Over here, y'all gonna be section number 3. Up there, like Freddie say, y'all section 8. Y'all can be with anybody y'all wanna be. All right, section number 1. Y'all say, one time. Y'all got it? Section number 2. Y'all say, 2 times. Y'all got it? Section number 3 and section 8. Y'all say, bum, 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 bum. Y'all got it? Y'all got it? Oh, we gonna practice this shit because y'all ain't gonna make me look bad. Section number 1, what y'all folks say? Oh, look at them. Section number 2, what y'all folks say? Oh, they swinging. Section number 3, what y'all folks say? And go out and tell your best friend about your man. We're going to change the words around just a little bit. Don't nobody be trying to remix. Throwing in their little old two-seater. sing Acapulco. That means I'ma sing it by myself. Got no music. Then he gonna bring the music in if he got the right song. We gonna catch up if it's off a little bit. Don't worry about it. Be professional. All right? When I point to you, that's when it's your part. All right? All right. Now I can't sing. I'm a comedian. So if y'all happen to laugh at my singing, the shit work out. I'm a little whorish. I mean, voice. I'm sorry. Right word, wrong night. Here we go. Me. You. Here we go. Y'all ready? Mr. DJ, when I do this, yeah, that's when you bring music in, okay? You got the right song, don't you? Which one you got? Oh, okay. All right. That's my second choice, but we gonna work with it, all right? It is instrumental, right?
Yeah.
Okay, all
right. Let's get it going.
All right, Mr. DJ. Like you've been tearing shit up all night.
Come on, you wanna be Tony Braxton? Say that shit.
All right, whatever you say. That's all right. He gonna mess me up now, but that's all right. I'm a professional. I can sing Acapulco. You ready, Mr. DJ?
Yeah.
Okay, see, look, he got calm now and shit. You gotta put him in their place. DJ Kid Cadillac.
Straight to my eyes, strumming my
go out though, I like to leave you with a little joke. Y'all can go to work Monday and fuck up. Any secretaries in here? Ain't no secretary? Nobody take dictation? This man puts an ad in the paper for a secretarial position. You had to be able to type, run a computer, and be bilingual. Nobody answers the ad. He's about to take it out the paper one day when he hears a knock at the door. He goes to the door and there's a dog standing there. He said, "You applying for the job?" Dog said, "Ripper." He said, "Wait a minute. Can you type?" The dog said, "Roof." He said, "Type that letter." Dog typed a beautiful letter. He said, "We'll get you this time. Can you run a computer?" Dog said, "Roof." He said, "Run me a program." Dog ran off. I'm a program. He said, "We'll get you this time. Are you bilingual?" The dog said, "Meow." Listen, my name is Bobo Kyle. You better play on this. Thank you very much.
Keep it going, Miss Bobo Kyle. Hold on, baby. You got some reverb in the mic. Can you fix the mic for us? I feel like I'm in a project basement all over again. Just take the reverb off. Just give me a straight mic. Ba ba ba. Can you do that? Okay, cool, cool. Y'all having a good time?
Yeah.
I said, are you having a good time?
Yeah.
Let's just keep it going, man. I got another special guest who came up tonight on his way to North Carolina. Came up and drove. I tell you no lie, these brothers, as soon as we leave, they're getting up out of here, I believe. This is a good friend of mine, a great friend, a funny, funny man. Seen him on Def Comedy Jam 2 seasons ago, doing his thing, standing ovation. You'll see him on the next season. Put your hands together for him. Showtime at the Apollo, the whole nine. Come on, clap. Make some noise. Bring the love for Wyatt, the one man riot. Y'all gotta shit when I come up here, huh? I make y'all gotta shit. Big ass, I got a moving chairs over the eyes, and moving chairs. I ain't gonna be up here dancing, singing. I ain't gonna be doing no dog impressions. I ain't doing none of that shit. Come up here, tell a few lies. Y'all like them? Cool. You know, fuck it. All y'all sitting up there in the balcony, all fat motherfuckers. Just fat. Look at the balcony, just shaking. Nobody sitting under the motherfucker. Screws about to fall out of the balcony. Look at that big motherfucker just sitting down. Look at this big ass. Big white motherfucker, too. Probably eating niggas. Oh, big Jeffrey Dahmer looking motherfucker. Look at him. Look at this big motherfucker walking at security. Look at this big motherfucker. What you eat, people? This big fucker, you? You probably take a bath in pieces. I put my arm in there tonight. Put my leg in there tomorrow. Sit your big ass down. You fart, you'll warm this whole fucking place up. You need some heat in this motherfucker. Shit. There you are. Yep, I'm making somebody else got a shit. Look at that. Yeah, go ahead and do your business, baby. Yeah, run up there. Don't trip. You drop them glasses, you be blind.
Bathroom!
Nice shit. Ooh, I like this. This is nice. Crowded, too. We're standing room only in this motherfucker. What's this, Liberace shit up here? Y'all got the Camay lady up there. Look at that shit up there. Yo, Camay lady, way up near the top. Y'all holding a hostage up here. Nice shit, nice shit. Nice, nice, yeah. Them motherfuckers just quiet now, huh? I ain't gonna fuck with nobody. I don't fuck with nobody too often. I just, no, reflect the shirt on. So he don't be hit by, like, now you walking with a limp. You walking like he just finished shit. Look at him. I know your shit stink. You know your shit stink when you shit and somebody starts spraying up under the door? or they rolling them red bombs in there on your ass. Boy, I tell you, I'm a little pissed off, man, because summertime is coming right back around, and a lot of y'all fellas did the same shit you did last year. You sat on your ass and hibernated all winter. Ain't do no push-ups, no sit-ups, and ain't nothing in the world worse than a brother who come outside in the summertime, ain't do no push-ups, no sit-ups. He got on a little tank top shirt. You ever seen that shirt? Try to play basketball and a titty fall right out of his shirt. I'm not passing the ball if you got a titty hanging out your shirt. I'm letting you know that. And you know you out of shape when your woman's sucking your titty when you fucking. You way out of shape. Tell my baby, why you always sucking the left one? Why you always sucking the left one? I got two. And it ain't just the fellas, ladies. Some of y'all better get your asses in shape. Let y'all know everything in them stores don't fit you. I saw some of you coming in wearing spandex and your ass look like grits. Make a motherfucker want to put butter on your ass. Wearing them little short shirts and your stomach look like broccoli and cheese. All wobbly. Like you just had a baby. Get your asses in shape. A lot of y'all come out and stuff and talk about, oh, I'm going to go to Go-Go Club to make me some money. Don't go to Go-Go Club if your ass is fucked up. You are wasting people money. I spend good money in them clubs. $5, $6, $7 maybe a month in them motherfucking clubs. And y'all stand there dancing, your ass all crashed up, banged up. Well, I went to this one Go-Go Club, man. These girls had the worst ass I've ever seen in my life. Big ass dips in the ass, bullet wounds. With a damn girl down in front of me with a knife hanging right out of her ass. Leaking blood all over my lap. What the fuck? Get your... Telling you, get in shape. And y'all ladies, y'all gotta stop running so much game on fellas. Especially you little fine motherfuckers. I hate you. Hate you little fine asses. I don't deal with nothing but ugly women. Ass crack ugly. Cause fine women never had no damn cars. But ugly women have Ferraris. You seen the glove? Let me get in the car. Pretty women always, you gonna come pick me up? Babe, you know it's 4 in the morning? Yeah, I know. All right, you gonna give me some position when you get there? We'll talk about it when you get here. Get there and she got 4 of her friends with her, right? You're like, what the fuck? I got a new trick for all the ladies. If I come pick up you and your 4 friends at 4 in the morning, all 4 of y'all on them up. You might well bend your asses over. Some of y'all live in some scary ass neighborhood, decrepit. Just scary. I met this girl named Shelly. She ain't even live in Brooklyn, she lived in Brook. They stole the lint off the back of the shit. No damn police protection in the neighborhood. Trains didn't stop there. We had to jump off the train. Then she talking about, oh, I live right over there around the corner. So we walk into her block, right? We get to the corner, she's like, oh shit, hold on. I gotta let them know we coming. A dumb move. You know, dumb with the guns and shit. She peeking around the corner yelling. All right, you motherfuckers. Y'all know me. Shelly. I got this other motherfucker with me, too. So y'all better be cool. All right, baby, stay behind me. I got on my vest. No apartment numbers on none of the buildings on the block. I said, baby, where the numbers on the buildings? She said, oh, that's so we don't get no warrants around here. But I nailed the ass. And I learned something new, man. I learned something new. Some of y'all fellas, y'all gotta take care of these ladies with their foreplay, you know? Y'all gotta, because sex is good if you know what the hell you're doing. A lot of y'all don't. A lot of y'all are folks too young. I'm 31. I know what the fuck I'm doing now. Took me a long time. Just married yesterday. I know what I'm doing. First of all, foreplay is important. And for all y'all fellas with them sharp toenails, get them shits cut. Standing there just trying to slide her drawers on, raking her ass the fuck up. You gotta get your toenails cut, baby. And then everybody think they the expert head giver. And man, I hate it. Man, shit. Man, you can't eat every fucking thing you see. Let y'all know that. Y'all motherfucker, man, shit, I go deep sea dive. I don't give a fuck. You cannot. Some of that shit is warped. Warped like hell. You ever run into a girl with them big ass lips? You ever run into them? Y'all fellas ran into them. Lips just hanging on like this. You take them off. You trying to handle your business. You see the lips. Fuck it. I still got to handle my business. You know, you go down, you holding the lips, and you taking care of business, too. You. And the lips get wet and slip out your hand and got you in the right. One word of advice too. Y'all ladies gotta stop complaining about us coming quick. Cause we try. We fucking try. We give our all some nights. It's just, sometimes it's just so fucking good. Sometimes, you just can't. You be trying, we try everything. We take our little ginsengs, you know? We take our wood roots. You know, we do all your drinks and shit, and all your time. It's just some nights y'all are so wet. It should be called a buzzer. You ever run into them nice? You have the elbow? You can't hang on. You try. You try. You come in there like a cowboy. You like, shut the fuck up. Push it. You mount that motherfucker. But you can't hang on with two, three good strokes. Whoa!
Greatest pussy. Oh my goodness, I think I'm coming.
Blow me down.
I had to quit. Sitting there watching regular shows, Archie Bunker, All in the Family. You know, I be thinking stupid stuff because I'm smoking that shit. I'm saying stuff like, damn, I bet you Edith Bunker is a big freak. Because anybody as dizzy as Edith will probably do any damn thing in bed. I can see it now. Edith been horny all day waiting for Archie to come home. Archie get home, she just get happy.
Take a tail, work it out. I call a psychic hotline, and the lady is still alive. trip, you gonna try and save this motherfucker, what?
Stink there, bitch.
You be like, oh my god, woo! Shit, look at him!
sound like Jamaican music. Stay out of trouble with Jamaican shit. Is Jamaican music the shit? We love it. Love it.
See, there's one problem. How many of y'all know the words to the songs?
See, that's where the problem starts. But it's not really a problem for us white people. We don't care. Because as long as the beat is slamming, we don't give a shit what the record is saying. Right or wrong? The record can be straight up disrespecting us. We'll still dance to it. We be in the clubs requesting the shit. The record can be like, come and say, lazy ass American, them don't care. Come and say, all I'm ever do is collect welfare. We be like, that's the shit. But be careful, because they think they slick. They are the most non-creative music makers in out there. They take everything and do the shit over. And they think we stupid and don't know that's another one somebody else's shit. Just throw it on a Rockets beat and we done. I'll be peeping it. You gotta be careful. You know how they trick you? They keep telling you it's some new shit. So in your mind, you're thinking, oh, this is new shit. Just to disguise it. Like you see him at the club, you see him at the club, start talking to you first. Ladies and gentlemen, calm down, selector, calm down. 1997, calm down. Calm down. It's a new one, that's a new one. It's a new one, new tune. From Clinty Ranks. Yeah, that shit is back. Clinty Ranks. Ha ha. Clinty, hold up, nigga, hold up. That's Clint Eastwood. Ain't no Clinty Ranks. That's the good, the bad, the ugly. I got a movie. I got the shit at home. That ain't slick. Better play some other shit. We not stupid. All right. Got me on that one. I have a new one. Come on, selector, the new one. New one. Yes. Yes. You be like, oh shit, yeah, this sound new. Yeah, like this is new. For you, Trevor. There are two new weed spots on the block. I want you to go and blow the blood clot off the place. Now, Trevor, hold on. If you're not hearing this message the first time, don't worry. You have to come back and rewind one time. Rewind that shit. I said, cut it off, goddamn. This shit is nice. All 20 of us is having a good time. Love music. I love missing. That's still everybody's shit, ain't she? Everybody's shit. And she's popping, she's bringing popping back. And they hit you with the hee. She gonna hit a nigga with the hee. You better hit me with some she. Don't hit me with no hee. All that shit. Who's SWV? You gotta listen to the lyrics in these songs. It's tasty like pastry. That's a yeast infection. That ain't no tasty like no pastry. I don't want no fucking pastry when I go down there, you stupid ass. Want it fresh. And there's no reason why I shouldn't be, ladies. Y'all got all types of stuff in the store. All types of stuff. Summer's Eve, summery day, night before Eve. Mastin Gill, Johnny Gill. Y'all got all kind of stuff. Don't make no kind of sense. Too much bullshit. Sisters and y'all know all that stuff. Love me. I can tell a lot about a woman by just looking at her. I'm that type of brother. I can tell a lot about you. You look like a real sensitive sister too. Are you? You not? You just thank heifer or something? Give you the benefit.
sensitive shit. I don't give a fuck about a nigga. I don't care. Seriously, I'm looking at you. You look like, you know, let me see. Let me get it right up in your face.
Ah, you look good.
Let's see.
Yeah?
Just like I thought. You look like a girl that used to be scared of the nigga.